Hey guys, it's Gadget, and right now I'm going to hit live on Facebook and everything because I want this to go out both live and everything. So here we go. So going live. Three, two. Let's see, waiting for comments to appear. As you guys see, waiting for comments to appear. All right, let's see. Come on, people, where are you? When I have the ears on, there's a reason. Okay, I'm live on Facebook. All right, and I'm also here on YouTube. So if you guys see me on Facebook looking this way, that means I'm talking to YouTube as well as I'm talking to you guys, which I should do is do it this way and see if it'll actually stay. But the problem is that it's a phone and everything. But it actually does stay, so that's pretty good. All right, so I could talk to both of you at the same time. All right, so I don't know if anybody's coming on Facebook Live right now or... Hey, Christian, I am going crazy. The computer, like you see, is back up and everything. But I'm on YouTube right now recording as well as doing this live because there have been tons of rumors going around. And I've been getting phone calls all night and everything. And I need to put the rumors to rest because it not only affects me, it affects Christopher, and it's going to hurt him in the long run. All right? And this is where I need to put this to bed with everybody. I need to get everybody on the same page and everything because right now, like I said, I'm recording this on YouTube as well as going to Facebook Live. But first, because of my allergies, I'll be right back. So say hi to the guys behind me. Okay? All the little fun stuff and Felix. Okay? Okay. I am back. And the reason why that's there is because it's been freezing and I don't close windows in here because of the carbon monoxide leak that we have. Once the place is back in order, that's why I have to clean out the bedroom too because we have to figure out where it's coming from. All right, and that's why this place is like this. So that's one rumor. So I'm not a hoarder or anything. All right, the next thing I wanted to talk to you guys about is the fact that Luke Rich is still at it again and everything, and he was starting to harass all of my friends and everything. So this is the thing, guys. He gave me the hashtag Oscar the Grouch. He also calls me the village idiot and everything. And it's also, I found out, putting all the dislikes to my YouTube page. So I'm going to put a link for everybody once this video ends on live feed and everything, also on YouTube. I'm going to say it again. If anybody would like to hit that like button so that we can counteract all the dislikes that Luke is doing and everything and stuff, because he's the only one that YouTube has pinpointed is the only person that's keeping this up and everything. And everyone else has died out. They have even spread so many rumors, it's not funny, that have been debunked and everything. All right. So let's get into the fact about that. I'm not going to tell you that this latest rumor yet because that's the, I thought the icing on the cake was the last rumor and everything. All right. So this is where we're on the page right now. Okay. And I just got to fix my computer because my computer likes to time out after a while. So for all those on Facebook, I can add somebody if they want to talk with me or anything here on YouTube. I'm just going to rant like I always do. All right. Because one, all right. How do I put this? Christopher gave up on me before we even got to know each other. And he's been doing that for the past 4 years. He does that all the time, even when we were friends and best friends. All right? To get me back is why he said, I'll make you the girlfriend. Because the last time was a really bad breakup as friends and everything. Because he treated me very wrong and everything. And I looked through my YouTubes and I saw that it was on there because I mentioned it because it's part of another book series I was going to write. And everything, which I'm going to do once this book is finished. I'm going to go back into YouTube and get my notes on writing the second book I was going to do. And it was going to be based on all the guys that I have ever dated and everything. All right. So that's so far everything. Okay. I also have been, like I said, dealing with a sprained ankle, dealing with, we don't know what's going on with my job, dealing with family issues, all the other stuff and everything and stuff. So yeah, I have a lot on my plate. So I don't need the UK wonderful people basically trying to manipulate a situation that could have been resolved with me and Christopher if they had just fucking left us alone. All right. So that's where I'm trying to explain to everybody. I'm still friends with some of his friends. He's still friends with some of my friends. We all are on the same page. We're tired of this, but at the same time, at least I'm trying to fight back. Christopher is just laying there like a dead dog. All right. He's letting them manipulate him to the point, unless he's doing it to see if I would contact him and doing this little game and having Luke do all this. You guys don't understand. That is the wrong way to get through to me and everything. Being civil human beings is the best way to get through to me. So why am I going out Facebook Live and YouTube at the same time? Well, up until this point, there have been so many rumors going around that Christopher and Luke are together, all right, as boyfriend and boyfriend, that Christopher is bisexual, that he never really wanted me. I was a game in a game of a game that they were trying to play on somebody, okay? That Luke is his caretaker and everything, where the things, it just got to the point where when I hired a lawyer and I had other things going on, and YouTube as well as Facebook has been monitoring everything, they found that Christopher, over the years, has been telling half-truths about me. He's afraid to tell everybody the whole truth about me because it was an embarrassment to him, because his friends kept embarrassing him about us being together. Because Luke even told one of my friends that he wanted to rip me a new one because I wasn't a local girl and I was fighting with Christopher as a couple fights. Couples are allowed to fight and everything, but I didn't have the right to fight with Christopher as the way Luke was presenting himself to everyone. And there's actually documentation of that. All right. So it got to the point where, thank you. Okay. It got to the point where basically for over 2 years now, I've had to deal with Luke being the stupid idiot that he is because he's not being an adult and he's not acting right, because he already just threatened one of my other friends and everything, saying that they were going to tell me about this. No, I found out from other people, not only this one friend, because there's a lot of people, including Facebook and YouTube, that have been sending me stuff because it's part of an ongoing case and everything, that I have the choice now to either resolve it with them or bring up on things. But because the laws are different both in his area and mine, I would rather resolve this live like this with Christopher and everything, versus the fact of having to say, okay, fine and great and everything. Because one, all my Facebook has now not been public, and that's why they're putting all the dislikes on my YouTube and everything, because they can't see what I'm doing, because they think that, oh my God, she's probably talking about him again. That's where the paranoia with their side is. I have enough to deal with. I write for a podcast. I have to deal with my parents. I have to deal with a job. Christopher doesn't have a job unless he got one within the few months that I have not spoken to him. All right. I have to deal with my own life, my own health issues and everything. I have to deal with an apartment that I left alone because I had other things to do, because I put everybody else first and I didn't take care of me, because I was trying to make a relationship work, because I thought someone finally had woken up and actually wanted me for once in their life, instead of thinking the grass was greener on the other side and then months later come back again and say, okay, I was wrong. No. I gave him enough chances, he fucked it up, and his friends can't admit that. The same thing like Josh and Rachel. They're still on my YouTube page, right, as subscribers, and Josh gave $10 to my GoFundMe account for me to go see Christopher and everything, but then I'm the bad person, which he says I'm not appropriate for Christopher. Who gives them the right to dictate how Christopher should and should not have a relationship? That's up to Christopher and me, or Christopher or me, and everything. So when all the rumors started and I get all these phone calls, because I found out Luke has been putting people up as well as other things that they see on Christopher's page and taking it upon themselves to belittle and harass me, I stand up for myself and I'm considered the bitch, the witch, and everything else. Okay, fine and great. Been called that my whole life. My name is Felicia. Okay, you know what? Okay, fine and great. But I have my real friends, my family, my true friends who know who I am and what I do and everything. And yes, would stand by me. But when I did ask for help, most of you said, forget it, he's a waste and all the other stuff. But that's the difference with me. And maybe that's why I'm a little quirky with some things, or kooky or whatever. Because I value human life. I was sheltered. I was belittled. All the stuff growing up. So I don't like seeing other people be that and everything. But when I know the truth and I stand up for myself, I should not have to be told, walk away. No, because I let too many people walk over me as I walked away and get away with many lies and everything else. So this one is not getting away with it, because it's not hurting only me and him, but his friends are hurting him to the point where either he's faking these live feeds so people will contact me and make me feel bad, which I don't feel bad because he did it to himself by trusting people who don't even know the situation, and by him telling them half-truths about me. Because like I said, when Gwen first became my friend, she didn't realize I was the girl who was going to the consulate. I was doing all the medical stuff for him. I have his paperwork. He faxed all that stuff to me. I made the trips, wasting metro cards and bus fares and phone bills, just so I could find out why he couldn't come here. Also, calling doctors and everything, setting up appointments in L.A. for him with certain doctors because of the trigeminal neuralgia, which we found out later he does not have. All right? But where was Gwen, Jen, Ed, anybody else to see this, okay? Why was it put on me, all right? Because that's the type of person I am. I was a friend to him. I was the true friend. And I'm going to say that because I don't see any of you. I don't see Luke. I don't see Josh, Rachel, any of them busting their butt to say, okay, let's help him get to see her or this. Except for that one time Josh did, like I said, put the $10. But then, you know what? If he wants his money back because I'm a bitch and everything and I'm so much of a bad person, he can come to America and get his $10. All right? So where am I going with this? Well, this is where it gets better. I had over 100 phone calls from July through now, people calling me. It started to die down. And it died down after the last YouTube I did where basically it's said that Christopher had a sex change operation because I said to the person on the phone, good, I can't fit in some of my clothes. I know he's skinny. He could fit in some of my old clothes when I was acting. It's a junior size 9 and everything and stuff and all that. He could basically go and I'll send it to him. Just tell me where to send it to him. They hung up the phone very fast. I thought everything died down until I found out from people after my computer had crashed and everything that he was my friends were being harassed and everything by Luke. So I'm like, what the hell's going on now? So what do? I'm like, okay, I got to go to YouTube. I find out that also a guy I was promoting, his girlfriend or whatever, is like thinking that everything I talk to you guys about here, as well as YouTube and everything else, right, on Facebook thing, thinks that it's about her and him. And I'm like, this girl is a psycho, right? So I had to put everything on private. The minute I did that, here comes all the dislikes, the bad comments, and I keep trying to tell people on YouTube, if you are blocked on my YouTube page, you cannot see comments. Your comments won't be seen. There's certain words that will not be seen. You have to go through a filter. Like, one guy said that, like, I know Tara Strong, like, she's a friend of mine on Facebook and everything. I feel bad for what happened to her. But when I questioned somebody about it, because they didn't know what DC and Marvel was, and when I said that in a conversation, they're like, you don't know her. I don't know her in person, but I know her through everything else. I know her through friends and stuff, and I've met her one time at New York Comic Con, but she was in the middle of signing autographs and everything, and it was a 5-second thing. But she knows of me. She knows who I am. Because of a lot of friends in the voiceover world and everything. But we're not close like that, but I still consider her a friend because I feel bad for what happened to her and everything and stuff. Because there's different forms of friendships and everything. But the fact that the matter of with this, with me and Christopher, I thought they were done with everything. Because remember, I told you guys out what happened and everything, and I'm going to use an analogy for it. This was my heart when I went out there. This is my heart now. Okay? Because of what he did and said. He said his friends, writings, and travels comes first, okay? He said that basically he talked to two other girls before he even saw me out there, and everyone made the decision for him, and he thought he could change his mind. Now, also, I'm writing a book, guys, and none of the people's, everybody's names have been changed. So unless you have something to hide or you didn't do anything, like, you know what I mean? Then you'll be nervous. But if you didn't do anything wrong to me, you have nothing to worry about. And plus, it's only about my trip with Christopher. It's not about you little idiots and everything and stuff. So that's what I wanted to make clear, too. So here's the other thing, also, that I'm pissed about now. There has been another rumor going around that I got phone calls on. And one of my friends, who still talks to Christopher, even sent something to Christopher because we need to find out. And I think we're now going to be both on the same page where we're going to kill people. In the sense of enough is enough, people. Because according to the rumor, and I said this live yesterday, now I said it on YouTube, I'm going to say it again. There is no baby. There is no child. There is no nothing. Okay? I got calls from 2:30 this morning, people wanting to buy a stroller, a plane ticket. Why didn't I have a baby shower? Why? I was a good, me and Christopher were playing this game. We were so like pretending to be broken up so that no one knew about it, to be surprising people. There is nothing. I couldn't even get the moron to take his shorts off. He put a pillow in front of him. All right? He chickened out. All right? So that rumor going around, there is nothing. I appreciate the person who wanted to make me the Doctor Who stroller. Okay? But at the same time, people, there is nothing. All right? He chickened out. He gave up on the trip. So I had to give him up because I could not fight his views, Luke's views, Josh's views, all the other little idiots' views out there. So I just want to make this clear for YouTube and everything. Plus, I would like all of you on my Facebook page, as well as YouTube, as well as anything, could you please basically hit the like button on my YouTube? Because thanks to the UK, because there is an analytical, depending on how you say it, shows where all the dislikes and everything are coming from. And the UK is running tops. And even YouTube has said the activity has been like, and I said, yeah, that's when I turned my Facebook to private and everything. They go, oh, okay, we know what it is and everything. And they traced all the URLs and the IP addresses and everything. And guess what? Stop making fake sites, people. That's the other thing that's been going on. And as to my cousins who I just met, I am not this wacky and everything. It's just that you caught me in a situation where I had to deal with someone who wanted me as their girlfriend, who kept it a little secret in 2015 until he had to make it known in 2016 because people were also bullying me because they didn't want to see us together. And then you had the people that wanted us together. But the people that won out were the people who didn't want us together. And that was because I had to give him up. And I know it's like you're caught in the middle and everything, guys, and everything. Just take it with a grain of salt. My friends on here will tell you who I am and everything. I am a good person and everything who just got caught up in where someone who has such low self-esteem, according to what Lucas said, which I don't think so that he has, you know what I mean? He just is going, they're just basically in the situation making it worse for him. Because I'm fine. I'm moving forward. And you know why all this started about the little like news and everything and stuff? Because I put on my Facebook page that I was got some good news. And you know what I mean? I have to wait a year for it. Right? So you know the telephone game where everyone does telephone. So by the time it got to Luke and Christopher and everybody and stuff like that, they all just presume that my good news was that and everything. And I'm like, no, guys. It's not even my good news to tell anybody. Because it pertains to someone I know or something I know or someone I know. You know what I mean? Okay. I'm not telling you what it is because it's a catalyst that goes with it. And it would benefit things and stuff, but it's not my good news. It's per se in the field of where I would get good news because I have been waiting a long time for this good news and everything. But at the same time, guys, I'm going to tell you right now. Enough with the rumors, enough with everything else. You guys are running out of things to make this like the most interesting thing, all right? So like I said, if any of you want to see my YouTube, I'm actually going to probably post the YouTube as well as the live feed because it's the same thing going on. That way on Facebook, if you missed my live feed, you could see the YouTube part of it and stuff because I'm not turning the live feed off because I'm also going to talk about other things on here because like I said, if you're blocked on my YouTube, or blocked on Facebook, I'm not going to see or know anything, all right? The only way I find out stuff is YouTube contacts me, Facebook contacts me, people who are being harassed by people are contacting me, and also the rumor mill people, which is just making me laugh because you guys, you know what? It's just funny as fuck, all right? Do you think this is bugging me? No. It just makes me go, okay, I'm going to have to, if I ever marry Christopher, you guys know I'm joking about this, right? Because that poor soul of a slob, spoiled brat will never, never admit he fell for me. I'm going to have to put Luke in a pink tuxedo. I'm going to have to put Josh in a pink tuxedo. Actually, no, a pink dress for all of them. Since they wanted to be the little girls in the relationship and be the little little scatterbuggies and everything. Little hens of this and everything. You know? Because I am tired of this. I really am. And I'm not tired in the sense of, oh, you know what? It's no. I'm just tired because they're wasting their money, their time, which they have, I don't understand how they have a lot of free time on their hands. Because right now I have to go finish a kitchen. Okay. I have to finish a bathroom all by myself. I'm waiting for my dad to come back. Maybe he can help me with the garbage and stuff and everything. But he had an appointment to go to. All right. Because I can't do those stairs anymore with my ankle. It just got the swelling down and I went to go try to get the mail and no, it hurts. Okay. I could punch a wall in right now. All right. But I thought you guys would get a kick out of the fact the latest rumor is that, see, I love when that thing goes off because it tells me that it's actually true. Like, this is a rumor that is true. That people are spreading a rumor that my good news is that me and Christopher are having a kid. No, I couldn't get the moron's pants off. He put a pillow in front of him. He freaked out every time. All right? Nothing happened. All right? He gave up before he even got to know me. All right? He wanted a physical relationship, but he couldn't do anything. And you know what? He's not the first one of my exes that couldn't. We have one called Deadwood. Yes, we call him Deadwood. And his friends gave him that one. And this was one back a while. And some of his friends are still on my Facebook page. All right? So, yeah. So, Christopher's not the first one to be getting like nicknames and everything. But Luke's nickname is Vanity Smurf. So, if you guys, since Luke gave me the hashtag Oscar the Grouch, and he says I live in a garbage can and I'm the village idiot and everything, would you like to please spread that hashtag? Hashtag Vanity Fair. Like, oh, sorry, so, not Vanity, Vanity Smurf and everything, because he is fair of skin, you know? Because you know what? Vanity, you know? He wants, Luke wants Christopher with someone who basically is like a rich person that could take care of him, local girl. But meanwhile, Samantha was not even a local girl, and she lived here in the States, but she had money and a house, and you know what I mean? So, where was Luke's priorities and everything and stuff? Plus, Luke has a wife and a child. According to the last thing I saw when he sent me the nasty email 2 years ago and everything. So basically, I'm trying to figure out here how he's got the time when he's got a wife and child to be butting into my relationship with Christopher and everything, where I Christopher has other friends who have met me and love me and told me that it's like, okay, even one friend that him and his sister are friends with, she sent me an email thinking she was going to curse me out and give me words and everything until she saw everything and she's like, oh, you two would have been perfect for each other. It's all on Christopher. It's not on me. They never let me and Christopher fix this. They never let us grieve. They never let us work this out. And they said a little bullying doesn't hurt anybody. Now, you want to laugh who Christopher hangs out with? 20-year-olds. 20 and 30-year-olds. All right? Especially the 20-year-olds in this day and age, they don't realize unless they that what they're doing as adults is still wrong and everything. But everyone says, oh, ignore it. No, when I called the bully hotline, adult bullying is different from children bullying. Children will give up when they see a new toy or anything like that. Adults will keep it up. And I keep warning you people. All right? The way I was raised, the way I was dealt with and everything and stuff like that, I'll let you keep it going until you guys tire yourself out. Because that's how I am when I babysit. Let them cry it out. I ain't go like it. Let them cry it out. You're entertaining it. Just let them cry it out. They'll eventually stop. They'll cry it out 10 minutes later. 20, this one's going on a year. Because Christopher knows I am not gonna unblock him. He knows we're done and he doesn't want it done. And he's gonna do all the stops and everything. I know the games that they're playing. So, either you guys wanna just bombard Christopher with the fact and send him some diapers if you want. Because I'll get, yeah, see, I don't wanna give his address, you know? But if you want to send him some diapers, you guys can find out and everything and stuff. But I'm going to be honest with you guys, that latest rumor that you're saying that me and Christopher have a kid or anything, not nah. I told you. Couldn't even get his shorts off, couldn't even get anything. All right, he chickened out, he gave up, you know? All right, it's in the book too, by the way. Oh, I didn't hold back on anything in this trip book. So you guys, even Christopher's friends are going to find out why, because Christopher is also welcome to basically write a book too, but he's gonna have to explain why he was on a podcast with people that never had a podcast. Yeah, that's Jessica, Steve, Angel, the other Alex he knows, and all them, right? That they canceled the podcast but left me downstairs for about 2 hours while his mother was out, bullshitting and everything. And I'm like, okay, they know I'm here. Why can't they just say, oh, go be with your girlfriend and everything, right? Or the fact that he ditched me for 2 18-year-olds in Cardiff and everything, playing tour guide when it was our only day there, full day and everything. And it was supposed to be our date and everything and stuff that he was promised he would make up for that after he fucked up the whole thing and started one fight with me. Okay? Because we were supposed to go to his grandmother's and that didn't happen and everything. And with all the stuff going on with his dad and everything else, you know? So he's going to have to write that version of it and everything. How he stayed in his room, how he did this and everything. Ignore, he sat in his chair and watched podcasts of all my friends and everything. All right. He basically just is gonna have to write that. How he jumped to the next couch when his mother came in after we were cuddling and stuff. He's going to have to write that. He's gonna have to write how he told me all the other stuff about all the other girls. He's gonna have to tell me all the other, you know? He's gonna have to write his version of how he slept upstairs in his room while I was downstairs talking with his parents and everything. Or how he stayed in his room and everything. And how, yes, I didn't want to talk to him at first and everything, and I locked him in his room and everything. But he was the one who basically contacted my friends and didn't come down after to let me calm down and everything and stuff. And talk it out with me. He just basically stood, knelt down and just looked at me. And I'm like, yeah, you better start talking. And he didn't talk. So I was getting out of, you know. So you guys are going to understand. There has been a lot of things that, yeah, this would have worked with me and Christopher. If he wasn't a manipulating, spoiled brat and roping his parents into things. All right. So I just wanted to debunk half the rumors that have been going around. And I don't need a baby stroller. I don't need anything. I don't think he needs a crib because someone was going to buy a crib and send it to him. All right. All right, so my good news is not that, people. All right? I wish it was that kind of good news, but I can't have kids. All right? I can't have kids. Not going to be in... Nope, sorry. I can't, unless I adopt or unless... You know, nope, sorry. My good news doesn't even pertain to me. My good news is part of what is going to happen. All right? So, you guys, here's the deal. I'm going to tell you right now. Could you please... tell your little friend Luke Rich to back the fuck off. Go be with his wife Andrea and his child and everything. All right? Let Christopher grieve. Let me resolve what I have to resolve. Because life is too friggin' damn short to be keeping this up and fighting. If Christopher really wanted me in his life, he would stand up to Luke. He would tell everybody the truth and everything about what happened. And he would not belittle me the way he's been belittling me. He would have not made the decision based on what two other girls told him because they are jealous fucks, okay? Because this is the thing about me, guys. Why should I be jealous of Christopher and Luke and everybody? I have the same morons here in the United States, all right? I dated the same stuff here in the United States, so I don't need to be jealous of anything, all right? I don't need to be jealous they're married. You know what? It's a ball and chain headache, all right? Why am I envious? What? Of what? Do I want to be envious of that? Paranoia and schizophrenia, like, you know, paranoia, mood swings, all that stuff, drug addicts, things like that, you know? Things like, no. All right, no. I mean, they just found a pot farm in Bishop Ackland where he lives, you know what I mean? So, no. Sorry, guys. I'm not envious of that. You know what? You can go right in my building and get the same thing, all right? What else? Hateful. Do I hate him? No. I hate the actions that Luke and Christopher are doing because this is the stupidity on that part and it's making entertainment for me. So if Luke claims that I'm entertainment, I thank them for giving me the entertainment to give to you guys because, you know, I just got, you know, I would love to have the entertainment purposes. I would love to have the time to sit there and watch my best friend's ex-girlfriend while my wife is taking care of my child type of situation thing, you know? I would love that and everything and stuff. So that's why I'm going live to you guys here as well as YouTube. Because I'm recording the same stuff. All right. And it looks like I'm looking this way because I keep forgetting the camera's here and I put the phone there so that I can actually look at the camera and everything and stuff. All right. But like I said, don't need strollers. Don't need anything. Sorry, guys. And people calling me at 2 o'clock in the morning from England and everything. You guys, listen, look, I was going to tease one of his friends and say, you want to come to the baby shower? It seems that me and Christopher are having a child, you know? But his friends weren't on this morning and stuff. So I wanted to let you guys know that this is the latest rumor going on because all I posted was I have good news coming my way. And it's not even my good news. You know, that's the sad part about this and everything. So that's been my day today, trying to deal with things and stuff and everything. And I hope that if any of you out there are watching this or anything, please go to my YouTube. I'll put the link again and everything and stuff. I'll go, because I have Facebook up too and everything. Yeah. Because Luke keeps putting dislikes, and I know where it's coming from, because like I said, on YouTube, you can hit everything and figure out who's got the device, who's got whatever. They're using Androids, Windows, ISO devices out in the UK. You can see what times they're doing it, all the other stuff, and the demographics, and it's a male. It's a male demographic, all right? So it could be Christopher, too, and everything. But it's, at this point right now, enough, guys. We've gotten to the point where now you're hurting him as well. And we're back to full circle when they started saying that Christopher was bisexual and they had Luke and him sleeping together. All right. So This has got to stop, guys. All right? I mean, I love the fact you guys are coming up with these cool-ass rumors and everything, but I've got things to do. You know, I've got to write. I've got to deal with an apartment, a crazy-ass cat. I've got to deal with my family. I got to start getting the business off the ground. I got to do a lot of friggin' stuff, you know? So I don't have time now to entertain the babies in the UK and everything and all the other stuff, because I think that's what it is. Because I've taken away, sorry, this thing's going off. That's the truth. Every time that goes off, it's the truth. See? I have, because I went private, all this other stuff. I guess they don't have their play toy anymore. So like a child, when they don't have their toy is broken, or they don't have their toy anymore, or it's disappeared, they're crying and they got to make up other stories and everything just to get that toy to come back. And that's sad, because that's only hurting Christopher. It's not hurting me. Guys, I'm a victim of abuse. Domestic, verbal, child. Okay? You can't do any much to me. This is cold. This is an empath. That's why I'm an empath, because I can only feel what other people feel, because my feelings are, you know? So let the little narcissistic, spoiled brat deal what he has to deal with and everything, because it was his own fault. And until he tells the truth, you know, I know I'm not going to get an apology, but I just love the fact that the latest rumor is that people are asking me, why didn't I have a baby shower? Or does Christopher need a crib? Or is this there? Does he need diaper? Oh. So guys, well, you ponder this, watch this later and everything, here on YouTube and everything, I'm going to say to all of you, as I go to make sure this is good and everything, please check out my YouTube page. Check out the real stories and everything and stuff. Because if you don't watch all of them in sequence, you're not going to know what happened. And especially 4 years worth of me and Christopher, it was funny as hell. Because I put down every time he left me and everything, and I'm watching through them because I was looking for the idea I did for a book on dating and everything that I had posted because of what Christopher did, and I was explaining about all my exes and stuff and everything. And it's just to the point now where, Luke, just keep it up, Vanity Smurf, because, you know, you're fair is fair. You know, fair is fair. You know, you want your 15 minutes of fame. I will give you your 15 minutes of fame. I just want to know why you're going to make sure your friend is miserable for the rest of his life. Because it's going to get only worse if I ever find anybody. Or do I have anybody? You guys will never know. And that's what's going to hurt him more, because he lost and missed out on his chance because he listened to all of you instead of his own brain and his own heart. So if he wants to keep listening to you guys, fine and great. But I have things to do, and I'm going to be moving forward, and I'm going to be talking more about other things that are coming up. But if I do hear one more mention that Luke is harassing my friends, as well as my family and other things and stuff, as well as the fact that this other girl is harassing everybody because she thinks that things I talk about on here is about her and her boyfriend and everything and stuff. I mean, this is crazy that these people, I don't know where the batshit crazies find me. And I'm sorry for all the cursing through this and everything. But what are you going to do when you have to deal with this and stuff? But I wanted you guys to know that the latest rumor is not true. We didn't fake this fight because of trying to hide something and everything that you guys think is my good news. No. Mm-mm. Guys, me and Christopher are going to fight to the day we both die. But I don't believe that this fight was caused because of things. I believe it was caused because outside influences manipulated the situation. And I'm telling you right now this. Whatever happens, I'm not responsible for it, nor do I know what the fuck is going on unless you guys tell me. And you guys only tell me because either he wants to contact me, and I'm not going to talk to him because that's not the civil way an adult does it. Because every time he breaks up with me, he does it over the computer, and he doesn't talk to me. He hides. So as far as I know, this is another one of our little fights that you guys had to initiate because you like to see drama between me and him, and you're not hurting me, you're hurting him. And that's where I hate all of you, in the sense that your actions are hurting him. Now, if he's playing this manipulation game where he's pretending to be hurt and making you guys think he is, then who really got played in all this? All right? So have fun today, guys, and enjoy the day. And I don't need a baby stroller. So whoever that Doctor Who person was that was going to make me a baby stroller with a TARDIS and everything, I thank you, but no. Okay? Maybe years from now if I can adopt or anything, but no, guys, there is nothing between me and Christopher. Nothing happened out there. Couldn't even get his shorts off. He put a pillow in front of him. Okay, guys, I tried. He just didn't want to go through it because he, for some reason, he was going based on what his friends told him. And you know what? They won out. So, yeah. So, bye for now. I'm going to post my YouTube as well as you guys see this. But it's the same thing on YouTube that I put here. And hopefully you guys can come to my YouTube page and click the like button because the UK keeps knocking me down with dislikes and everything. And I really don't like that fact because they can't see my Facebook page. All right. So talk to you guys soon. And let me turn off both of you guys at the same time. And I'm going to say I love you to all. And once again, Christopher, if you want this to end, you better get on Skype and talk with me, or you better call my house, or you better come here in person, because the only way I'll accept an apology is if you're here in person. And live, meaning I'm putting you on blast and I'm putting you on YouTube and Facebook Live, because I am not having you back out like you've always had and telling half-truths about me. All right? And this message goes out to him. You want this to end? Tell your friends to back off and back off my friends. We all can be civil. I'm civil with your friends. They don't bring you up or anything and stuff. They don't ask me about anything. I just say I like their pictures and everything. All right? So please, let your friend Luke be civil with my friends that are still friends with you, because that is not right. All right? If he's harassing them, they're going to tell me, because like I said, the UK police wants every time he harasses, because that's not right. See, and that's true when that thing goes off. So once again, I shout you out. Christopher, if you want this to resolve because they're claiming that we are having a child, all right, you better either talk to your friend or talk to whatever, or you better get on Skype and talk. Because we need to figure this out right now, because if this is a way and a tactic for them to get us to talk again, it is the worst tactic going. It makes people jump to conclusions and everything. All right? So no, unless you are physically in my presence and resolve this with everybody, I will not accept an apology. And I know I'm not going to get an apology because you don't want to be proven wrong. And you know what? You will be proven wrong. Because until you own up to the fact that you created this mess, this is going to keep going on, and I'm still going to ignore everybody, but if they are harassing, I'm going to go do what I'm doing now. All right? So good luck, guys. I got to make sure I hit this button without dropping the phone, and I got the other one. So I'll talk to you guys soon. Peace out, and have fun. Bye.